I'm Richard Gomez. Today, we have news in Jerusalem. We have a winter storm warning in effect. We have more information and details. Bob, you there?
Richard, yes, Richard, I can barely hear you. I'm here in Jerusalem. It's raining and it is very, very windy. 60 to 70 mile hour winds coming at me right now. I can barely hear you, Richard. Tonight we're gonna see storms, thunderstorms, and snowstorms. 5 to 7 feet of accumulations. Check back later on. We'll give you some more details. Oh my God!
There you go.
Salam, asal wahima ajan muhabid al shabar bitahna merkazia illa wisin al wasi kaisulwa isilwa hanivi illa sambidi ahnin.
Surveillance cameras have changed the way we live, being placed in buildings, homes, and schools alike, and it's been raising eyebrows in western parts of Jerusalem.
A delivery man has been caught stealing on surveillance in this local yeshiva.
It's mamish scary. It gives me the chills.
Students and rabbis alike are now on alert. Hey, Mikdash Melech Rabbi, Rabbi Gil has been speaking with concerned students on Wednesday morning.
The teacher and the students should know that the yeshiva and I are doing the best we can to keep the situation from escalating.
The company for which the man works for has been contacted and they are looking more into the situation.
The administration of Yeshivat Mikdash Melech, Shlomo Erez, and the police department of Israel are trying to get this robber, and we have to show him that robbery will not prevail.
This local yeshiva is not taking any chances. In the Ramat Shlomo section of Jerusalem, I'm Ralph Shasho, MMJ Channel 11 News.
A rabbi is sitting behind bars accused of trying to swindle several companies out of tens of thousands of dollars of an elaborate scheme. CBS 4 to explain what police happened here. Gio?
Elliot, we're talking about alleged insurance fraud. The old rabbi was arrested here at MIA today and then faced a bond court judge.
Filing insurance claims with American Express and Allianz Global Assistance, two companies which provide travel. Investigators say he pocketed more than $30,000 since 2006. The rabbi asked the judge to release him and tried setting his own rules. The judge set the rabbi's bond at $110,000, in part because police say they found 73 fraudulent transactions. That's 73 counts of grand theft, false insurance claims, and false supporting insurance documents.
Hello, I am Tom Brokaw.
And I am Ben San Antonas.
It seems Rabbi Gil has returned from the moon, landing in the Indian Ocean.
Two Indian pirates found him helpless and agreed to help him if he followed their demands.
Hello, my name is Arkadik Pradakadar. I plan on letting the rabbi go free. But murder because of a haircut? I will blow up the whole arcade!
The pirate blew up the entire arcade. In other news, investigators have new information linking a May-Aden delivery man in confederation with a Mikdash Melech rabbi.
Analysts say the rabbi hired the man to rob the yeshiva and make sure he was seen on surveillance so that the yeshiva can use the footage as a threat against the company.
MMJ News correspondent Judiah Rachmanai has more on this story.
Thank you, Tom. I'm standing outside here in front of Mikdash Melech.
Yes, what you've been hearing is true. Rabbi Gil has been seen acquainting himself numerous times around the country and even Gaza. He's been laundering money, exchanging weapons, and even smuggling 12 tons of black pepper.
Yo, this is Judah Rachmanai reporting live from Mikdash Melech. Back to you, Tom Brady.
Thank you, Judiah. Exclusive footage has been recovered, unmasking the strange phenomenon of why the yeshiva's food is so unbearably spicy. The same rabbi that has been caught laundering money, exchanging weapons with terrorists, and smuggling extreme amounts of black pepper was caught in the act of secretly spicing the yeshiva's food, so he can subsequently put the blame on the innocent cook. But before we show you the footage, we have exclusive interviews from the criminal himself.
Rabbi Gil, what do you have to say on the matter?
Hello, I'm confused. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say! I don't just know what to say!
Here is the latest footage. We have a Damascus Gate analyst with some new info that may shock you.
Spectators are outraged at the shocking news of how the rabbi can betray them. Riots and chaos have rocked the building. Staff members and attendants are too scared to intervene.
Security systems have made void the building's insurance coverage due to the extensive damage of the building from the riots. What will be the rabbi's next scheme? Find out after the break.
Hello, I'm Roger M. Blake at BPPS, the Black Pepper Poisoning Society. Days, weeks, months, and even years go by without a single recognition of how many children are suffering from black pepper poisoning. Here at BPPS, we devote our love, time, care, and shelter for victims who have been brutally abused by their faculty members. We, with our utmost affection and dedication, have shown that these victims can be helped. And that's why we're asking you for your help. To donate, log on to our website at www.bpps.org or call us at 1-888-400-BPPS. That's 1-888-400-2777. Why wait another second? Call now.
Hi, I'm Ralph Shasho, and I approve of this message.
The following episode has been brought to you by May Balabi. There's water, and there's water. May Balabi, the black man's choice.
Alright guys, sorry I'm late.
Hey,
let's get started over here. Alright, let's go. Alright, on the count of three, you're gonna start our mountain climbers. Alright, if you're down the floor, get your feet out, if you're doing a push-up, you're gonna come in like this. Put your feet up, like you're climbing your mountain. Alright, on three, one, two, three, let's go. Find those mountains, baby. Come on, burn those calories. You can do this. Theo, you got it, baby. Come on, keep climbing. Keep climbing. Let's go. Let's go, Vladimir. Come on, you got this.
I got this.
Almost there, guys. And five. And four.
Yeah,
and
three.
And two. And one. All right, we're jumping jacks now also. Just to warm ourselves up. All right. On three, guys. Ready? One, two, three. 19, 18, 17. Let's go. No, I want to see those hands in the air. Let's go. And two, and one. Very good, guys. Very good. I'm very proud of you guys. We're going to take a break now. All right? Catch your breath. Go drink some Maybalby. All right? And we'll be right back shortly. Okay? I'm very proud. Very good. Very
save
good.
Save me a cup.
Thanks. Dion, you have an extra cup, maybe? Some Balby water?
Yeah. Hey, say something.
I want to find out what's causing this.
We'll do that. Sir, you figure out the problem. There seems to be a parasite on Wall Street. Symptoms start at the eye with some brief hallucinations, and everything goes downhill from there.
Doc,
it's the Prime Minister.
Mr. Prime Minister?
Previously on Contaminated.
One, two, three. Nice. Dion, you have an extra cup, maybe? Some Balby water?
Where's the doctor?
Where's the doctor? Where's the
doctor? Where's the doctor? Clear! Come on, Thomas!
I want to find out what's causing this.
Joseph, this parasite had to come from somewhere. I want detectives on the case. I want you to trace the thing. I want to know where this thing came from!
Sir, involve the FBI, involve the Mossad, the CIA. Get on it as soon as possible.
Thank you.
Steve.
Hi, Rabbi. So listen, we have a problem.
Uh-huh.
So in the gym today, there were a couple of guys that I saw. I don't want to mention names, but they broke the dumbbell, which cost about 200 shekel. And also there was Olympic weight, which cost, I don't know how much, 300-400 shekel.
So do we have any more money to buy equipment?
Buy equipment? Rabbi, we don't even have enough money to buy water for each month.
Steve, one second. I have a call on the other line. 1 minute. Oh, Steve, it's a very important call. Just stay on the line. 1 minute. Hey, Jack. How you doing? What happened? The game room? What happened? Oh, a ping pong ball got lost. And a chess piece. And the speaker's a little staticky. Don't worry, it's gonna be on top of the line. Jack, your game room is priority. Alright, okay, bye. Sorry, Steve. So about the gym, it looks like you're gonna have to wait until the finish with the building, until we get enough money. For now, I can't do anything. I can't get you a sponsor.
Can't get a sponsor to the end? That's crazy. I don't even know what to do now. Okay, fine. Yeah, can we at least get some cleaning, maintenance in the building for the gym? You know, it's always been dusty. People have been getting sick down there. Hygiene, something.
Yeah,
can we get Bellamy at least? Yeah. Maybe down to once a week, twice
no problem,
a week.
Steve. Okay, bye. Hello, Jack? Yeah, Jack, I got us a full sponsor. He's a sponsor of 1 million ping pong balls, 10,000 checker sets, chess sets, and he's gonna take away the little static sound from the speakers. Yeah.
United we stand for Shasho.
Howdy y'all, I'm Jack Vanderbilt.
And I'm Smooth Ross.
We're from Jack Vanderbilt Guns & Co. You know, hunting season's coming around. So why don't y'all like onto our website and all your guns now. Or for your Amish people out there, you can go visit our warehouses between Interstate 95, between Marcusville and Happiness Valley.
Vanderbilt's the place to go. Have a happy hunting season, y'all.
Contamination of fresh water.
So you understand? When you wash your hands or you do something like that, it gets into you. You understand? Very simple as that.
We gotta touch our eyes, bro.
If you touch your eyes.
Exactly. That's how my grandmama Peggy died.
Oh, shoot! Oh. Now, alright. Peggy, if, God forbid, it will go into anyone of us, it would be fatal. Just like a
it's good. Why? It's good now. They're mostly transmitted by the contaminated fresh water, right? So if the water you come in contact with your hand, and then you'll touch your open body parts, like your nose, your mouth,
even your eyes.
Oh, yeah. Your eyes.
Yeah. Grandma Bunny!
Dr. Grossman's office? Mm-hmm. Okay. Alright. Appointment at 2:30. Tomorrow. Okay.
This episode has been dedicated in memory of Grandmama Peggy. May she rest in peace.
Hey Jack, how are you? Bacon? Yeah, bacon, yeah. Should have it with eggs. Yeah, eggs. Eggs, yeah, it's very good with eggs. Should have it with eggs.
Dr. Grossman's office? Mm-hmm. Okay. Alright, appointment at 2:30, tomorrow. Okay.
Come in.
I have a 2:30 appointment.
Yes, room 27. Doctor will be right with you.
Come in!
Yes.
Come, please. Oh. Rabbi, have a seat.
Oh, thank you.
So tell me, Rabbi, what have you been experiencing in the past couple of days, huh?
Doctor, I've been experiencing major hallucination issues.
Mm-hmm. Like what?
Life.
So, two things we can do. Number one, you can take your elbow off my table.
Sorry.
Don't. Number two, we will perform a couple of tests. Ready?
Okay.
Okay, so... Yeah, this is... Rabbi, can you please read to me this sentence?
Mutar laniach tefillin balayla.
Ah.
Okay, please close it and kiss it. So we're going to run a couple of more... tests. Alright, please explain to me.
What do you see?
Toothbrush.
One more time. What do you see?
Toothbrush.
It's a menorah.
No, it's a toothbrush.
Okay, fine. Now, alright, please, I don't know where your old glasses went, but please put these on. Okay, so I'm going to ask you to identify couple of people you might have, you might know. Do you know this man?
Jack Dabo.
Mm-hmm. Jack. One more time.
Yeah, Jack Dabo.
Mm-hmm. And him?
Jack Dabo.
And the last one, him.
Hey, that's me and Jack Dabo.
You got a nice tan.
Yeah.
This is not Jack Dabo, this is his brother. Victor.
Jacob.
Now look to the
startles and tell me what you see. I see me eating my heart out.
Mm-hmm. Look closer.
I see me eating my heart out.
Okay, do not elaborate.
I see me eating my heart out. I see me eating my heart out. Okay, fine. So, Rabbi, it seems to me you have a very, very severe case of egoistic balamitis. Class C. In Hebrew, we call this cafe shako. One final test, Rabbi, if you don't mind. Please tell me what this is to you.
It's not a straight line.
You messed up his line! You messed up his line! Hold back!
It's crooked.
This?
Crooked.
And how about this?
Wow, straight.
Levante.
So, Rabbi, unfortunately, it seems we have to probably put you under severe lockdown of patience.
Okay. Woman, is there gonna be food?
Yes, where we hook up the SYK, it's your chicken, we hook it up. Unlimited.
I remember last time I went to an event, Shabbaton at the Kotel.
Yeah, well, there, the one Lachmajin. No, don't worry, Rabbi, this will be good. Welcome to Machne Yehuda.
Shasho United. I stayed united with Shasho.
Say, I don't know what to say. I just don't know what to say.